Hi, and welcome back to the Blazor Puzzle. I'm Carl Franklin, VP of App VNext, and that's Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff, what's happening?
Hello, hello.
How you doing?
Oh, doing great, Carl. Looking forward to another puzzle here.
Yeah. So why don't you tell everybody what Blazor Puzzle is?
So every show, we're going to introduce a little bit of Blazor code, and it might not work. There might be some kind of coding challenge that's involved there that we need your help solving.
Yeah. You'll have to use your brain. You can use Bing. You can use Google. Use whatever you want, but figure it out, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And if you know the answer, if you think you know the answer, is what you should not do is post it on social media.
Right, because you don't want to spoil the puzzle for everyone else. Instead, email your answer to blazorpuzzle@appvnext.com.
That's right. So we're going to pick a winner from all the correct answers, and that person will win one of these, a Blazor puzzle mug, and a cool t-shirt, compliments of DevExpress.
Sweet. So what was the last puzzle, Carl?
All right. Well, if you go to github.com/BlazorPuzzle, this is the new home for all of our puzzles. Puzzles 1, 2, and 3 are right there. And this is puzzle 3. So you wrote this one. Jeff, why don't you tell us what it is?
So this is a puzzle where I was trying to write a website that would list out, here's a list of all of our episodes. And as I was writing the website with Razor Pages, I realized I should really write this with Blazor for a Blazor puzzle website.
Right.
So I migrated from Razor Pages to Blazor server side, and I was copying things over, and it just didn't start right. I converted everything over, and I thought I had it right. So I was looking for some help. Why isn't this starting?
Some help. I think you're beyond help, but let's see. Yeah, it's not starting. It's a 404 error.
Yep.
So we got a lot of answers for this one, right? A lot of correct answers.
Absolutely. A lot of correct answers. And quite simply, it was in the conversion that happens here under map Blazor hub there on line 23, we need to map fallback to page.
Just like that. And a lot of people got it.
Oh, yeah.
Do we get any wrong answers?
I didn't see any wrong answers. I think everybody got it right this time. Did I make it too easy, Carl?
That's what we said last time. But maybe you did. Maybe I did. I don't know. I guarantee you, though, this one isn't going to be easy. But first, let's get to the winner. And this week's winner is, drum roll, please, Joel Miller.
Joel!
We had, like I said, we got a lot of right answers, but Joel's going to be getting a Blazor mug and a t-shirt, and you have another t-shirt winner, right?
Yeah. So as we were standing up, you see the new Blazor puzzle organization out there on GitHub. As we were standing that up and we were copying out and standing up the other puzzles, somebody went and said, oh, I see the problem in your source code here, and sent us a pull request. Immediately with the answer, like, no. Yeah. So now you're going to see our repositories are marked as archived, so we can block anybody from spoiling it. But Sharaf Mansour,
all right,
came
Sharaf
through and had the solution for us almost immediately as we were putting together and starting to publish the source code in this new organization.
Now, don't think that by sending a pull request with the answer that you're going to get a free t-shirt no matter what. It just happened to be in the transition that Sharaf sent us a pull request.
You're going to see that our repositories are marked archived so that they're frozen in their puzzle state.
Right. Okay, so let us move on to the next puzzle. So in this puzzle, we are going to lazy load a big class. Well, I have a big class that makes a big DLL. It has 100,000 methods.
That's a lot to have running in the browser.
I know.
I mean,
I had to write a program to write this DLL with all these methods.
But if you did have a lot of business logic, a big class that's doing a lot of stuff that you want to run on the client, you might have something that is big and gnarly like that, huh?
Totally. Yeah, I mean, that's what lazy loading is all about. So take a look at this class. I've created this project, BigAssembly, and it has this bogus class in it. And now I have method 0 through method 99999.
It's a half a million lines of code.
Yeah, that's right.
If you can't break it really good.
All right, so now I have a Blazor WebAssembly application, and it's a standalone. And I'm including BigAssembly.dll. I have a reference from this to that, right? From BlazorPuzzle 4 to BigAssembly. And I'm using this Blazor WebAssembly lazy load include to make sure that I've got BigAssembly.dll.
Now, why would you use lazy loading, Carl?
Well, in this case, right, the whole, if you don't use lazy loading, the whole application will pause before you even get to Hello World. And while that big ass assembly is downloaded, you know, so the way I have it set up is I've got it on counter because I want to actually have a measurable time so that you can see in real time how long it takes to download.
Sure. Okay.
All right. So then the next step for lazy loading is you go to App.razor.
Yeah.
And we add this additional assemblies attribute or property on the router. Mm-hmm. And that's this list of assembly, lazy loaded assemblies. And then you handle the on navigate async. And I look to see if the path is counter. Then I look for that assemblies. I grab assemblies from assembly loader, load assemblies async. And if that assembly is in this list, it's going to be loaded. And if it's not in the list, no problem. It'll just skip over it. So what you're going to see, you know, when it works, is you're going to see the first time you go to the counter page, if you put a breakpoint here, this will have one assembly in it. And if you go back to home, let's say, or fetch data and then come back, put a breakpoint on, it will break, but assemblies will have nothing in it. We'll have no items. So if you go to counter, let's take a look here. So I'm injecting bogus class, and I added that
just
as a service.
Just like you normally do.
Yeah, you inject a class, right?
Okay.
Then, you know, in current count, load big library, I'm just going to call one of these methods before I increment the count.
So click the button, go call one of the methods on bogus thingy.
Right.
Makes sense?
All right. So here we go. Let's see what happens. And.
Okay.
Boom.
Decent load time. Wait a second.
An unhandled error has occurred. I didn't even go to counter. So the question is, why?
What happened?
What's broken? Okay. Try to figure it out. Now, if you think you know the answer, don't post it on social media because that wouldn't be fair to everybody else. Instead, send it to this address, blazorpuzzle@appvnext.com with the subject puzzle number 4. And we will send one of you a mug and a t-shirt. And here's the important thing, Jeff. It's really important that you get us your answer by next Tuesday, September 19th.
Yes. Right?
Because that's when we're going to record the next show. And therefore, we have to pick somebody by then. Okay?
All righty.
All right. We'll see you next week or next time, whenever that is. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazortrain.com and the.netshow.com for more great content.